power series.
What did I do wrong? Here's the question. We have this power series and we are given the radius of convergence is 5. And we are going to find the interval of convergence for the power series. Yep, definitely one of the hardest topics in Cal 2. Here we go. This is the power series and the capital R is the radius of convergence and the capital I is the interval of convergence. Well, in order to find out the I, of course, we will have to know the R first. And also, we need the center. And here's the idea. We have an interval. We need to know the center first. And let's say the center is somewhere right here. Let's call that to be A. From the center A, well, once we know the radius of convergence, we can go to the left R times. So we'll get here, let's say this is A minus R, and then we can also go from the center to the right R times. So this right here will be A plus R. Then as you can see, from here to here will give us the interval, but we have to be careful because we will also have to test out the convergence at the endpoints. So let me just put a question mark here and also a question mark right here. I will explain what I mean by that once we get to the actual question. So R is equal to 5, done. But how about the A from the power series though? Check this out. Here's the idea. If today we have a function written in its power series form, so the series Sn, let's say it starts with 1 to infinity. Right here, we'll have the coefficient sequence Cn. In this case, it is all this. And then we have the x part right here, of course. So let's say we have this times x minus whatever that number is. In fact, that number is the center of the power series. So that's the a and n to the nth power. The a right here is the center. So as you can see here, the center is 5. And also the radius of convergence is 5. So this might be one reason that this question is a little bit confusing. So now let's put all this together and see what we have. First, I'll just write down the capital I. This is going to be the following. Let's draw a number line. We are going to start with 5 because that's the center. So let me just put this down right here, 5. And then what we have to do is what? Starting from here, go to the left R times, which is 5 times. That means we get here and we get 0 because of what? Because 5 minus 5. Okay, let me see. Because of this 5 in blue minus the radius of convergence in red, so minus R. So this is the R is equal to 5. Okay, so 5 minus 5. And then we also go from the center to the right R times, so 5 plus 5, which is 10. So this is 5 plus 5. Just like what I was saying right here. Great. Now, here's the thing. The answer is not necessary from 0 to 10 because we also have to make sure that, hey, do we include a 0 or not? Do we include a 10 or not? So that's the hard part. Sometimes we do not include both endpoints. Sometimes we might just include one of them. And sometimes we might include both. So this is the bizarre part. But don't worry, I'll take care of you guys here. Let's go ahead and test this out. So right here, we are going to test the convergence for the power series. Right? Test the convergence for the power series. And the first number that we will do is add x. This right here is the interval. That tells you the x value. X equals 0. So test x equal to 0. So this means we will have to put 0 into this x here. And then look at this as a infinite series question. Does it converge or not? Putting the x equal to 0 in here, first we get the sum as n goes from 1 to infinity, and then just the rest, negative 1 to the m plus 1, and then 0 minus 5 to the nth power all over n 5 to the n, like that. Now we're just going to break this apart, simplify as much as possible. We have the series, n goes from 1 to infinity, negative 1 to the n plus 1, by the rule of exponent, we can say this is negative 1 to the n times negative 1 to the first. And then this right here is negative 5 to the n, which we can look at this as negative 1 times 5 and then to the n, which we can look at this as negative 1 to the n times 5 to the n. And then the bottom, just divide this by n times 5 to the n. It's pretty nice because the 5 to the n, 5 to the n cancel. And in fact, there are a few more things that we can do. For example, right here, we have negative 1 to the n combining with negative 1 to the n. It's just negative 1 to the 2n, which is just the same as what? It's just 1. But let me just perhaps write this down right here for you guys. Perhaps I'll write it down here. Negative 1 to the n times negative 1 to the first times negative 1 to the n. This and that combined is just negative 1 to the 2n at the exponents, and then times negative 1 to the first. This right here, negative 1 to the 2n, it's an even power, it's always 1. So 1 times negative 1. So in fact, you just get negative 1. So all this right here is just negative 1. So we have the series as n goes from 1 to infinity, when we have negative 1 on the top, over n. Okay? We can put a negative on the outside of the summation. So this is the negative sum n goes from 1 to infinity, 1 over n. And what's this series? The series in black. This right here is just the harmonic series, and we have a negative version of it. So this right here is the harmonic series. Or you can also look at this as the P series, n to the first power right here. Either way though, diverges. So you can just say that the harmonic series diverges. And if you multiply by a negative, still diverges anyway. So in fact, this right here, the power series does not converge at x equals 0. So I'm just going to cross this out. It does not converge over there. Okay? And then now, of course, we'll just test out when x is equal to 10. So now we just have to test out the 10. And this is when x is equal to 10. Put the 10 into this x and see what happens. We will then have the series as n goes from 1 to infinity, and then here is negative 1 to the n plus 1 times 10 minus 5 and then to the nth power over n times 5 to the nth power. This right here is just 5 to the n. And then for this, I will still break it apart for you. This right here is the series as n goes from 1 to infinity. We will just have negative 1 to the n times negative 1 to the first. And then this is just 5 to the n over n times 5 to the n. 5 to the n, 5 to the n cancel again. Here we have negative 1 to the first power is just negative 1. We can put on the outside one more time. And then this right here is the series as n goes from 1 to infinity. This time though, we have negative 1 raised to the nth power over n. So in this case here, what we have is the alternating version of the harmonic series. So we will just say that when we have an alternating harmonic series. And remember, the alternating version of the harmonic series converges. You can also check it with the alternating series test, but this right here converges. So right here, the 10 does work. So not including 0, but include a 10. Finally, I'll just write down the answer for you. The interval will be from 0 to 10, not including the 0, but we include a 10. Or of course, you can also write this as x has to be in between of 0 and 10, not including the 0, but we will have to include a 10. So this right here is the interval of convergence for that power series.